This is my KLX 125. These are from a Husqvarna, and I like how it kind of like blacks out the originally silver parts of the lower fork, but it still has some silver in it. It says Race Tech, which I enjoy. I did the Monster logo. The vinyl matches the green plastics perfectly. Seat's a little dirtier than I would like. I still haven't figured out a way to clean up the seat or get this auction number off of it. If anyone has some tips, leave them in the comments. I've cleaned up the plastics using a little blade to like scrape it, and I might get some acetone on there or something, I don't know. I put this tailbone or like skid pad padding on the tail because I ride with Zach, and now he rides up front so he can like help steer and lean more intuitively. I painted the engine black. This part is actually with the $1 Home Depot gloss spray paint. I love it. And up there is actually with the Duplo color high heat paint, and also on the exhaust. I didn't really spend a lot of time on the exhaust, and I actually have the cover that I did on in black. I just haven't put it on yet. So that makes it look a lot newer, as well as this new exhaust pipe. I'm not sure. I think it's for around the same year, Yamaha 125, even though this is a Kawasaki. But it looks a lot better. It's like that newer shape style. And I don't know if the camera's picking it up very well. But yeah, it came with that sticker on it. It was, I found it for 30 bucks on eBay. And it actually slips right on. The diameter is just a slight bit bigger. It actually slips on the stock manifold for the Kawasaki. And I just have it, I removed this panel, I guess. I haven't put the bolt back in. So you can see I just metal zip tied it up there into the existing bolt. I could have put it down there, but then it would have been tweaking the manifold, and that heats up and cools down, and I didn't want to have that cracker shear. So it's pretty well on there. You can see the bike moving. But I might also put like a spacer between here and another metal zip tie just to help fortify the stuck out. The original one stuck out. You can see that original mounting point that far instead of that far. And I laid it down two times on this side, and it kind of torqued the back of this. And so you can see it sheared off right here at this weld point, which is, I guess, the weak spot. And it's this basic shape. And I saw on eBay that this angle to where that mounting point was about the same. And so I was like, that might just slip on, and it did. So that's definitely a mod that you guys want to do if you get this bike. The only thing is you actually have to drill at an angle in here. I have 7 smaller holes, and then there's actually a wall here on this baffle. And so you have to actually drill into there with 2 deeper ones, and that's you can make bigger holes. But it's you have to like drill on an angle. So unless you're really good with a drill gun, find someone who's good at a drill gun to do that for you. At first I started opening it up down here, but that did not do much, so I would just say go in here. This does look kind of badass though, and it sounded pretty mean at first, but I found that this pipe is more restrictive, so I've been opening it up more and more, and every day I'm like, oh, that's good, and then I come back to it, I'm like, no more. Well, other mods I've done to this are that the grips are all torn up, so I got new Pro Taper grips. The grip is actually co-molded into the throttle sleeve on the original throttle setup. So you have to buy this CNC'd aluminum green anodized. Actually, you get whatever color you want. But that mounted up quite easily. The only thing is the threads that you can see here aren't actually in. But it's pretty good. If you've done a couple throttle cable bullshit rig ups before, you'll know how to do it. And snaps back. This little guy I discovered was the return spring, so it doesn't rotate forward anymore. That'll rattle out unless you tighten it down from eBay. I got this Kawasaki thing because the bar was actually slightly bent, so I pried that out and just slapped that on. And you would never know the difference, even though the way it's it's kind of swooped in. It's like it's bent, but it's not, I swear, anymore. Yeah, so these Bark Busters, Universal, these are great. Made the bike look a lot better. And then this is the bungee that I use to tow stuff, because apparently I love towing stuff on dirt bikes now. Let's see, I think that's about it on the mods. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed my take on the KLX 125. My original plans were not to touch it, just leave it stock, but that never seems to not happen. So yeah, hope you enjoyed the bike, and watch me catch some air in these next couple clips.